Hello friends, good to see you again through this video. Today I wanted to talk about one important question. Will positive confessions change our situation or circumstances? See, today we talk about this positive confessions, right? If you take in the world today, there are a lot of this motivational speakers or people, who do like a prep talk, they do it in the team meetings or like sometimes, in the office places or anywhere where they want to motivate the people, right? They go and say they talk about what you can achieve by your power and how you're going to contribute like that. They talk so many things, and every time, they also mention that you have to keep a good attitude. You should always think positive, just ignore your failures, keep your mind always set on the positive goals like that. That's all good, right? But my question today is, if I am going through a situation or circumstances in my life where I'm terribly facing a lot of issues and setbacks, right? But my question is, will just mere positive confession will change my situation or will change my circumstances? That is what we have to discuss today. So for that, I wanted to share one word from the Bible. It says in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21, this is what the Bible says. Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it will eat its fruits. So here the word of God says, that we have the words that we speak has power, right? Because it says death and life are in the power of the tongue. Just by merely doing a positive confession or just by merely encouraging a person by my own words, will it change their circumstances? Maybe it may help them to, stay motivated for a while, but will it change their circumstances and situation? It will definitely not, because I am just a human being and my words have limitations. I can say something which I can do for probably if I am working as a manager, I have some authority, right? And if I want to help somebody, maybe within my authority, whatever I can do, I can always do. But can I change a circumstances or a situation that is going in the life of a person or a pain that they are struggling in their heart? How can I change that with my own words? It is not at all possible. And that is where, we have to understand that what we speak is very, very important. Is it going to be our own words or is it going to be the word of the Lord or God's word that we are going to use in the situation and circumstances? Why I wanted to stress this point, that we have to use the God's word. We have to use the word of the Lord whenever we want to encourage or edify other people, because it says in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12, it talks about the significance of God's word. This is what it says. For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and of spirit, of joints and of marrow, and discerning the thoughts and intentions of the heart. See, what a great, powerful thing is God's word, right? And then we also see in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 11, God is saying this, my word that goes out of my mouth, it shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it. So the Lord is making it very clear that only when we apply God's word in a situation or circumstances, we are going to see the change happening. Because of one reason, that God's word is powerful and it is the only way where it can change the situation and circumstances. It can pierce the heart. Even the hardened heart can be pierced by God's word, so that it can be melted, and people will start to obey. People will start to bring the change in their mind, right? So today, my dear friends, the question before you and me is, when we encourage others or when we edify others, when we try to, motivate others, are we just using our words or just the words just to, give them some boost or give them some motivation? Or are we using the word of the Lord so that we allow the word of the Lord to take root in their life, and that will create the change and that will create the growth in them? See, that is why when we think about this question, how can I always, you know, be able to tell God's word, or how can I have the right kind of words for the person who's coming to me to ask some help, or like to ask some encouragement like that, right? So I have to be first abiding in the Lord. Because if my relationship with the Lord is not strong, if I don't have a good understanding of God's word, or if I don't practice God's word in my life, what happens? I won't be able to declare God's word in the person, in the other person's life. Because, you know, I myself is not sure how God's word will work, or I am reluctant to use God's word in my life, then I will be reluctant to use God's word for in other person's life also, right? So that is why God says we have to abide in Him, in His relationship, you know, meditate on His word, seek Him in the prayer, so that He will fill us with His word, and also Holy Spirit will help us to communicate the right words. Because today, if a person is coming to me and talking about his problem, right, I may not know the context, you know, I may not know what is the right way to respond to that, right? But the Holy Spirit knows what is the right context and how I should respond, and what is the word, you know, what is the right verse that will be helpful for them to be encouraged and to stay in faith, right? So that is why we need to be very, very sure that our relationship with the Lord and the way we practice the word is very important, right? Because James 1 verse 22 says, do not deceive yourselves just by mere listeners of the word, but also be doers of the word. See, when only when we become doers of the word, that is when we can also proclaim the word with authority, because we know how the word has transformed us, and we know for sure that the word will also transform others, right? So today the question before you and me is, are we just going to make positive confessions, or are we going to make confessions filled with God's word, so that, you know, people will be impacted by the God's word, and the God's word will take root in their heart, so that it will start the impact, it will create the impact, and it will start the growth in them, right? So one verse I wanted to share and close. If you read in Matthew chapter 4 verse 4, it says, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. So sometimes we think, like, you know, we are like not able to encourage and edify others because we lack what they need. But you know what? God's word, if you are able to share the word of God, if you are able to give the right kind of word, right word for them at the right situation, that itself will sustain them, and they will be able to overcome that situation. So today, my dear friends, let's be, you know, let's understand one thing, right? Like, you know, Jesus said it very clearly, that in this world we will all have tribulation. John chapter 16 verse 33, he said that we will have tribulations and we will have problems in this world. But he said, take heart that I have overcome the world. So today it is our responsibility to share the truth with everybody, right? Like, you know, whoever is burdened by the problems of the world, whoever is like facing an uncertain future and with a lot of doubts and uncertainties, it is our responsibility to tell them there is a hope and a future, and Jesus Christ holds the future for you. So don't worry. So we have to give the right words, and we have to give them the word of God, so that they will be able to hold on to it, and that will bring hope in their life. So today, are we doing just a mere positive confessions, or are we willing to share the word of God? Because the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 11, encourage one another and build one another, for this is the best way to do as brothers and sisters in Christ. So which means, when we encourage and edify each other, it cannot happen only by mere words of our own words. You know, we can be very eloquent, we can, you know, we can do a lot of good phrases and jargons, but still they are not going to change a situation or circumstances, or they are not going to change the heart of a person, because only God's word has the power to do that. So we have to always use God's word when we encourage others, when we talk to them, you know, when we try to motivate them, so that God's word, the power of God's word, will work in their life, and they will begin to see the change in their life. May the Lord bless this word. You all have a blessed and a happy day. God bless you.